With every NVIDIA driver update, it's like every update is getting bigger, more bloated, and taking up more disk space. Why? You might be thinking, can I just remove all of that trash and only install what I want? Yes, you can, and there's two apps that can do this. NVClean Install is an app I talked about 2 years ago. This app continues to be maintained, and as of this video, it supports the latest NVIDIA driver, 528.24. This app gives you a lot of options and flexibility. The video link is in the description. When you first run the app, your GPU or video card will be displayed. The next line will indicate the driver installed. The four sections to the right will indicate the driver type, whether it's 64-bit, mobile, or laptop, and if you have the studio version installed. When you're online, the Install Best Driver for My Hardware section is populated with the latest official driver. If you choose to manually select a driver version, this can be good if you want to install a driver you know works. Or if the latest official driver has issues with the app or game you're using, you can also select the studio version of the driver. This is more tailored to productivity apps like the Adobe Suite or DaVinci Resolve. When it comes to measurable performance differences, I haven't seen any performance benefit between the two versions. Let me know in the comments if you've seen anything different. There is a checkbox option to show all versions. I don't recommend selecting this option as you'll be presented with many older drivers. Most people won't find a benefit because these drivers will likely not support your GPU or running an older version of Windows. This is more of an advanced feature and should only be touched by people that know what they're doing. The third option is to use the drivers on disk. This is an excellent option if you're performing a clean installation, as well as for those that wish to remain offline during the driver installation process. The last two options are far less likely to be used. Installing NVCleanStall as an app instead of a portable, standalone app is not needed unless you plan to uninstall and reinstall drivers on a very frequent basis. Periodically checking for driver updates sort of defeats the purpose of sticking to a clean installation. You don't need to install every driver update. It may be best to stick to the old saying, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. After you hit next, the components displayed or listed are based on the choice you made. Older NVIDIA drivers will have different options. By default, only the display drivers chosen. However, if you make use of an HDMI or DisplayPort audio cable to your monitor or TV, as well as if you stream or make use of a capture card on a different computer, select the recommended option. If you're using a laptop or a notebook, you'll likely install the Optimus component. Check each of the options to see if you require them. Now, if you decide to use GeForce Experience, you can select only what you need, but there are dependencies. Be sure to check the description on the right to make sure you select those dependencies. If you don't, GeForce Experience will either not work or crash when you launch it. Once the app downloads the driver or looks at the driver you provided, you will then be presented with an installation tweak screen. This is based off the latest NVCleanStall version 1.15.1. If a newer app comes out after this video has been posted, or you use an older version of the NVCleanStall app, your options may differ. Let's go through the options. Display, installer, telemetry, and advertising can be selected unless you decide to use GeForce Experience. Unattended Express installation is just that. You don't do anything. Let the app run on its own. Allowing automatic reboots if needed should be off if you're running other stuff like Office Docs or music in the background. Perform a clean installation will wipe out anything related to NVIDIA off the system first. I don't check this option as I use DDU, otherwise known as Display Driver Uninstaller. Add hardware support is for advanced users. Enable DLS indicators not needed. Disable multiplane overlays experimental. It may address stuttering or can cause stutters. When you check Show Expert Tweaks, more options will be presented. Some of these are experimental. Disable driver telemetry. It no longer sends data such as hardware info from your PC and driver issues to NVIDIA. If you check this, the NVIDIA driver will need to be rebuilt and digitally signed once again. This could cause issues with apps like Faceit. Make sure to check the method compatible with Easy Anti-Cheat if you decide to use this. Automatically accept the driver unassigned warning can be checked. Disable NVIDIA container. This will stop the NVIDIA control panel from working, but it may break Windows borderless apps or games. Disable NVIDIA HD audio device sleep timer. This stops the HD audio driver from going to sleep. The default setting could prevent devices from waking up. It's recommended to check this option. enable message signal interrupts. It may have reduced or increased stuttering in Windows. Checking this option adds an interrupt policy and an interrupt priority. If a selection is made, change the interrupt priority to high. Disable HDCP. If you use any devices like a VR headset, don't disable this feature. Apply NVENC video encoding session limit patch. This removes an NVENC encoding session limit for consumer NVIDIA GPUs, like anything GeForce. This is experimental. It may have benefits for streamers who use NVENC or people who use productivity apps like Adobe Suite. Testing needs to be done to see if there's any real-world benefit. Start external application. I don't know what this does. Now when you click Next, you'll have three choices. Install, Show in Folder, or Build Package. This is the TLDR of the three options. Install, it begins the installation process right away, and once it's done, you can close nvcleaninstall. Show in Folder shows what the current extracted folder looks like before installing, and it's more for advanced users. Build Package creates an installer for future use. Let's build the package so we can reinstall it for later. Now let's install the package with the options we chose. The driver has been installed successfully. If you enabled MSI mode, you'll need to either reboot your PC or disable and re-enable your NVIDIA GPU. I will likely make a video on the second app, NVSlimmer. Let me know in the comments if you want to see one on this app. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. Consider supporting the channel by leaving a super thanks or becoming a member. Feel free to subscribe and turn on notifications. Let me know what you want to see next in the comments. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and we'll see you guys next time.